Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the new place. Praise the living God, brothers and sisters. Praise the living God. God is good all the time. All the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. You know, I'm tired, brothers and sisters. I've been moving and everything. And I'm out here. You probably can't hear it. It's nighttime already now because I've been busy today. I want to make a video all day, but it's nighttime. But I'm overlooking the ocean. About this house that we moved to is up on stilts, and then it has two floors. So out of the bedroom window, I can see, brothers and sisters, the ocean. As a matter of fact, there's some kind of a vampire family out there on the beach. I can hear them because we're near a pier. There's a family with a bunch of little kids out on the beach. It's like 11:30 at night here. And they've got their little kids out on the beach, and they're yelling and screaming, having fun. It's still hot, you know, down this way. It's about 70 or 71 degrees, you know, even at night. So it's still nice and warm out. But, you know, I've never seen people with little kids play on the beach at night. But, hey, more power to them. Anyway, I got some olive oil, brothers and sisters. The dear sister who's letting me stay in this rental property of hers until through this winter time, brothers and sisters, she brought me some olive oil today because she saw my video also. I ask you to pray for that sister. I'll give her first name is Mary. I ask you to pray for her. She's getting ready to travel to Dallas. She has some relatives in Dallas that she will visit. And then she has she will go from there and visit. She has a brother who has cancer. And I'll ask you to pray for him too. And pray for that family. And, you know, there's lots of people that need prayer. But I ask you to pray for this sister Mary, who allowed me to stay here. That the Lord will return to her 100-fold. You know, and she bought me the olive oil. I've got 4 half-liters of olive oil here. So that's 4 pints of olive oil. I'm going to get some more. I'm also going to buy some frankincense. I used to have some frankincense before. I think I bought it at a Whole Foods. They were selling all this stuff, and I saw they had myrrh and frankincense and all this. So I bought it, and I took it, and I showed it to a Sunday school class I was teaching. Hey, look at this. You know, here's some frankincense and myrrh. So I took some frankincense and put it in oil before. I still have some left, some anointing oil with frankincense in it. And it really smells good. You know, that's what they used, you know, to offer, before in the Old Testament. Sometimes they're using frankincense, you know, as the incense. What we call today incense, they use frankincense when they offered it to the Lord in the temple. Of course, we're not in the Old Testament, brothers and sisters. We offer up, you know, our sacrifices of praise, and we offer up, you know, the praises of our lips, and not in a temple made with hands. But brothers and sisters, it's just a reminder, just like people who are wanting to, check out and see what all they do in these feast days. Of course, we don't have to follow the feast days. But, and I don't sit around saying that people should follow the feast days. But in those feasts, we can learn more about the Lord, you know. And so usually you hear me on here talking about how, you know, of course, Christians who are trying to say you got to celebrate those feasts of Israel when the Lord was talking to Israel. If you don't participate, then you're not really a Christian. Of course, that's on one extreme. But the other extreme is, of course, we don't throw away the Old Testament. It's there. The Ten Commandments are still our guide. And let me just say this. I don't know why I got on this topic. As the Lord was leading me. Jesus took the Ten Commandments to a new level, brothers and sisters. You know, before when I've done videos on grace, you know, you can't say everything in every video. I've done videos on grace, and someone had said that, you know, Brother Patrick doesn't believe in the Ten Commandments. I didn't say that. I say the Lord made it higher. Jesus said, you've heard it been said, thou shalt not commit adultery. Jesus said, they quoted from the Ten Commandments. But I say to you, whoever looks on a woman in lust has already committed adultery in your heart. Jesus took it to a higher level. Just like in the Old Testament, it talks about tithing. And the New Testament says God loves a cheerful giver. It's a whole nother level. It's not just, oh, I got to go give my tithe. In the New Testament, the Lord is seeing that we are cheerful in our giving, not just giving, just like, okay, don't commit adultery. Boom. I didn't commit adultery. Boom. Tithing is not the Ten Commandments, but as an example, giving. Boom, I did that. But God is saying, he's looking at the thoughts and intents of your heart. As a Christian, Jesus said, if you look on a woman with lust, you've already committed adultery. The Old Testament and the Ten Commandments doesn't say that. You can look all you want, but you don't touch. You can read the menu, but not order. You know, that's the saying that people say, you can read the menu, but you can't make an order. No, Jesus is saying you can't, you're not even supposed to be looking and lusting. Jesus said, you've heard it's been written, thou shalt not commit a murder. Ten Commandments. But I say unto you, he who is angry with his brother without a cause has already committed murder in his heart. See? So the Lord Jesus has taken it to a higher level. And in giving, he said, with the same measure you measure, it'll be measured back to you. With judging other people, with the same measure you judge, it'll be judged back to you, Jesus said. So you're judging hard on people, the Lord's going to judge hard on you. That's what he said. With the same measure you use, it'll be measured back to you. With giving, he said, if you give, it'll be given unto you in good measure, pressed down and running over. Will men give into your bosom? And then he says, with the same measure you give, it'll be given back to you. He who sows sparingly reaps sparingly. Everything with God. You know, the people talk about the prosperity gospel, and some of the prosperity gospel people have run wild with it and taken it overboard. Just like people trying to say you have to wear a yarmulke and a prayer shawl and celebrate the feast or you're not a Christian. Same thing with people who are saying that, you know, God wants to make everybody a millionaire. God wants, you know, that's been taken over the limit, brothers and sisters. We have to keep everything in balance. You can't outgive God in anything, brothers and sisters. Anything you do is sowing the seeds that the Lord gave you. When you go evangelize somebody, you're sowing the seeds of the gospel. When you give money to build an orphanage, you're sowing seeds for the gospel. When you go pray for somebody at the hospital, you're sowing seeds of the gospel. When you visit someone in prison, when they were naked, you know, as Jesus said, when I was naked, you clothed me. Matthew chapter 25. When I was in prison, you visited me. When I was sick, you came and visited me. You know, these are the seeds that we have. So we all have seeds, whether it be a good talker. Some of you are not good talkers. Lots of people couldn't make a video like this. They don't have those seeds in them to do that, but they have the seeds to pray for people. You know, they have the seeds to go make some food and carry it to their neighbor who's sick and give them a Bible or whatever. Tell them about Jesus or call me up and say, Brother Patrick, can you come see, you know, you're going to be here. Can you come see my neighbor and tell them about Jesus? Because, you know, I just don't really have a good, you know, a talent in it, but I've already got a relationship with this person. I want to bring you in. So, we all work together for God's glory, brothers and sisters. So I've already got oil by the grace of God. I'm going to be praying over it. I'm going to get some frankincense. I believe I can get it at Whole Foods. I don't know if there's one around here. I'll find a place. Put some frankincense in it. Just you guys to pray about it. I'm going to get some little bottles, like with a little twist top, like a little shampoo bottle you get at a hotel. Something about that size, like 1 ounce or a half ounce. Something like that. Because when you anoint somebody, just use a few drops. Let me give one reference, scripture reference. The oil represents the Holy Spirit. But it is not the Holy Spirit. It represents it. Now, one Bible verse is James chapter 5. At the end of that chapter, it says, if any sick among you, let him call for the elders of the church and let them anoint him with oil, and the prayer of faith shall heal the sick. So if you hear that, the prayer of faith heals the sick. But it says to anoint him with oil. Oil is a point of contact. Just like Paul had handkerchiefs. You know, there are some ministries that did that, and people are talking junk about them. Hey, and these old Pharisees, they say, oh, it's not biblical. Yeah, it is. Paul, the Apostle Paul, was busy, and he prayed over handkerchiefs, and they sent them out, and they touched people, and they healed them. Peter, the shadow of Peter, healed people when it fell on people. God does unusual miracles. It's a point of contact. It's a point of faith, brothers and sisters. Just like the woman with the issue of blood, she said, if I can touch the hem of Jesus' garment, I'll be made whole. So she reached out, she acted on it. She touched the hem of his garment. She was made whole. Her faith could have been just like the other one that said, you know, the blind man outside Jericho, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. He kept calling. Jesus turned around and came to him. What can I do for you that I might receive my sight? Jesus laid hands on him, prayed for him. He received his sight. This woman didn't say, oh, he's got to lay hands on me. Oh, he's got to talk to me. If I can touch the hem of his garment, I'll be made whole. That was her point of faith. God knows what's our point of faith. So lots of people, their point of faith is, oh, you've got this oil that was prayed over and, you know, fasted and prayed over by a pastor. I believe if you anoint me with that, it's just like that pastor being here laying hands on me. And that's a point of faith. It represents the Holy Spirit. God honors our faith. And he honors those who honor his people. Yes, no, there's a balance there too. Some churches are cults of personality. You know, they make almost idol out of their pastor. And then lots of people on YouTube are at the other extreme of that. They dishonor God's servants. And lots of people I deal with, those old knucklehead trolls, lots of them are dishonor God's servant. You know, I'm nobody. But to God, I am one of his servants. And Jesus said, you know, what you've done to the least of these, my brethren, you've done it unto me. Anyone who gives a cup of water, cold water, to a prophet in the name of a prophet will get the reward of a prophet. So it's true, brothers and sisters, God does have, there are men of God, servants of God, and God honors those people who serve him. And he does deal with people that mess with them. Sometimes it's by judgment and sometimes it's by grace. He delivers them. God is the judge of all of those things, brothers and sisters. So we must have balance in all of those things. I guess that's my message. But anyway, I'll be trying to get together with this oil. And as I mentioned before, we'll figure out a way people would help with shipping. There's people that don't have money, people in other countries. It might be a little bit expensive. I'm not sure. If we're going to send it to other countries, you know, and that's my plan. And, you know, that's why if the Lord's going to make a way, if people help pay for the shipping, handling, and the little bottles and all that, shouldn't be too much. And I want to make like a pamphlet to go with each bottle of oil, brothers and sisters. I'm going to make a pamphlet, and I'm going to put prayers in there. No, not some set prayer, but an outline of a prayer for salvation, for healing, for being baptized in the Holy Spirit. I want to make a little booklet to go with it. As a matter of fact, I should write a book to go with it, because when I wrote my first book, brothers and sisters, those of you who watch my videos, you know I wrote a book. Praise the Lord. I just sold, by the grace of God, another 45 books went out this last week. Praise God Almighty. Praise God Almighty. Since God has been moving in this situation, since I got all the books in my possession, brothers and sisters, by the grace of God, I think we had about 200 books that sold and went out. So praise God. Praise God. We didn't have much movement on the book before, but now the books are moving. God is making a way. You can know, if you want a signed copy, you can just, you know, contact me by email, but there's a website. It's patrickwinfrey.com. And the proceeds of the book, brothers and sisters, of the love offering that people would make that would buy it, goes to the orphanage. I'll send you a signed copy. A lot of people nowadays are using Kindle and all that stuff, brothers and sisters. You get on Amazon and all that, and then the proceeds even won't be signed. Of course, it's electronic. We'll go to the orphanages, brothers and sisters. So I ask you to consider that. Final boarding call. Satan's plan for the ages is in our last mission before we're out of here, brothers and sisters. Thank Brother Andrew Cassell there in England who made the cover for me. Brothers and sisters, so I'm got a two-book contract that I have, and I've got to finish the other one by May, I think it is, or June. So I might just write that book, brothers and sisters. I wanted to write about all the experiences I've had with the Lord, but maybe I'll make a book about these different topics that I'm just talking about, to go with the anointing oil. You know, a study guide, like a one-chapter study guide, and prayers for baptism of the Holy Spirit. And then, a chapter and prayers for healing. And a chapter and prayers, of course, salvation. All of those kind of things. I might do that. I could put experiences to go with each topic of when the Lord has used me to lead people to the Lord supernaturally, baptize the Holy Spirit and all that stuff. Anyway, brothers and sisters, ask you to pray about it. You know, I made the video the other day as the Lord directed me to ask the minister, Pastor Paul Begley to join me, that we would pray that God would send revival on his people. And it's totally up to him. I know he's a busy man. I heard back from him, and it's from his wife, and I think they're praying about it. So I asked you guys to pray about it. It's all about unity, brothers and sisters. We will never agree on every doctrine. In essentials, unity; non-essentials, diversity; and all things, love. We will never agree on anything. I know that Pastor Paul Begley doesn't necessarily believe in a pre-tribulation rapture, and I do. It doesn't matter. We're born-again Christians, brothers and sisters. No matter what denomination that you belong to or don't belong to a denomination, it doesn't matter. If you're a born-again Christian now, I'm not talking about, as I said, cults, Jehovah's Witnesses, Mormons, or anything like that. I'm talking about born-again Christians. The Lord wants us to have unity among the brethren. Psalm 133, how good and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. It is like the oil even that ran down from Aaron's beard, even to his garments, even to the hems of his garments. The anointing comes down from the head, Jesus, down to the garment, down to the body, down all the way to the whole body. That's us, brothers and sisters. We want to be filled with the Holy Spirit. We want to be anointed. And that's really why I wrote this book. I just keep mentioning it because I want to get this message out there. And, of course, the proceeds for the orphanages. Brothers and sisters, that's what it is. Our last mission. Everybody, almost all the people I talk to, they're talking about, oh, the rapture is going to be tomorrow. The rapture is going to be next week. It's a blood moons and all that. We're supposed to be looking up, but the Lord wants you to stop thinking about yourself and think about those people that will be left behind if you don't give them the gospel. That's what, that's basically what I'm telling this book. We need revival. We need God to move. Revival is a sovereign move of God. I mentioned this many times. There's a video. It's 34 minutes long, approximately. It's called Revival Hymnal, or the Revival Hymn. I challenge you to go listen to it. That's the truth, the real gospel. What is real revival? Not a series of meetings, but a sovereign move of God. That's what we need. And people say, oh, well, there's a great falling away, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, and so who died and told you that the great falling away is today and the Lord's coming tomorrow, and so let all these people go to hell? You've stopped thinking about yourself and your own personal escape. That's the reason why, if you listen, I believe in the pre-tribulation rapture. But people that don't, that's what they say, and it's true. There's lots of people that are just, forget everybody else. Let everybody else go to hell, literally. Let them go to hell. And let me go in the rapture now, Lord. Who cares? They're all evil. Let them die. God, that is not the Spirit of God. Just like Jesus called John and James the sons of thunder when they wanted him to call down fire on the Samaritan town because they wouldn't feed, receive and, give the welcome wagon to Jesus. He said, John and James said, hey, Lord, you want us to call down fire from heaven? And the Lord called them sons of thunder. I believe that's in Mark. And Jesus said, you know not what spirit you're of. I didn't come to destroy man's lives, but to save them. That's what Jesus came. Jesus came, said to them then, and Jesus said, I came to seek and save the lost. That's our mission. That's our mission. While we're looking up, Jesus has his body. Like the song by Casting Crowns, if we are the body, go listen to that. If we are the body, why aren't our feet going? Why aren't our hands healing? Those of you who watch my videos, I can't do it by myself. Paul Begley can't do it by himself. Minister Paul can't do it by himself. Whoever all the other watchmen are, I can't start naming names. I'm just mentioning ordained ministers right now. We can't do it ourselves. There's not many who are laborers. What did Jesus say? What's the command the Lord gave us? He gave us a command. And when he was with the Samaritans, with the woman at the well, what did he say? He said, the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray ye the Lord of the harvest that he will send laborers into the field. The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. You know what? I bet half the people that I talk to have been called by God to do the ministry, but they refuse to obey the Lord. What is the parable that Jesus told? He was talking about Israel, but in this case, he's also talking about lots of you guys. Listen to this parable that Jesus told, talking about Israel and then the Gentiles, but it applies to most of the people listening to this video. Jesus asked the Pharisees, he said to them, he said, a man had two sons. And he said to his first son, ye go into my field, go into my field and work. And the first son said, okay, I will. But then he didn't. And then the second son, he said, go into my field and work. And his second son said, no, I won't do it. But then later on, he did it. He did what his father asked him to do. And Jesus is talking. He said, oh, which one of these sons did right? And of course, the Jewish leader said, the second one, of course. So then Jesus said, don't you know this stone that the builders have rejected has become the head of the corner? Jesus was talking about himself. They rejected Jesus. Israel did. That's why there's the new covenant, the Gentile church, a new people, a peculiar people. But for you guys, there's lots of you in the beginning, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, 40 years ago, you told the Lord, yeah, Lord, I'll go for you. As God said to Isaiah in Isaiah chapter 6, when the year King Uzziah died, and Isaiah was in the temple ministering to the Lord, and he saw the Lord high and lifted up, and the trail of his robe filled the temple with glory. and the whole earth was filled with his glory. And then God, the Father, said to God, the Son, who will go for us? And Isaiah said, here I am, Lord, send me. But many of you have said, here I am, Lord, send me, but you didn't go. You were like the first son. You said, yeah, I'll go, but you didn't. But there are others of you who said no in the beginning, who will say yes now to the Lord. Jesus said, I didn't come for the righteous, but for the sinners. I come for the sick, the maimed, the halt. Praise God Almighty, I was found among the sick, not among the self-righteous. By the grace of the living God, by his sovereign will and move in my life, by his grace, Paul said, I am what I am. By God's grace, I am what I am. God came and found me sitting in the miry clay. He set my feet upon a rock. Hallelujah. He delivered me from the snare of the fowler, as it says in Psalm 91. The Lord has delivered me. And I pray right now that you will be delivered out of your own backward spelling of joy. I've mentioned this many times. The acronym JOY. Jesus first, others second, yourself last. But most people spell joy backwards. Yourself first, others second, Jesus last. Stop thinking about yourself. Stop thinking about yourselves. Think about Jesus first, others second, yourself last. Brothers and sisters, these are the last days. Today is the day and the time to get your rewards in heaven. Today is the day to win souls of men. Compel them to come in, the Lord commanded us. He sent us into the highways and hedges and compelled them to come in. Do your duty for the Lord right now. Do the will of God in your life right now, whether it's an intercessor, evangelism, donating, buying some of these books and handing them out if God wants you to, buying, you know, paying for a shipment of a liter of olive oil and going and giving it out to people, anointing people, praying for them. Whatever the Lord would have you do, go do it. Stop criticizing other people. Stop being critical of ministers. I'm tired of people being critical of everything and every preacher. As I said before, I could mention Santa Claus. Of course, we know Santa Claus is a fictional bunch of junk. I can mention Billy Graham, Franklin Graham. I could mention, I'm going to say their name, John Hagee. Anybody, Benny Hinn, whoever you want to talk about. I can mention the names and talk about unity. And sure enough, there's some old troll on there talking bad about that person. God didn't make you a judge over his servants. You need to stop worrying about looking for perfection. The only perfection is Jesus Christ. There is no perfection outside of Jesus Christ. All men have fallen short of the glory of God. But God does have imperfect men who are his servants. Imperfect people who serve him every day. And the Lord says, touch not my anointed and do my prophets no harm. Brothers and sisters, I'm going to close that with that. As this video started as a joyous video, it's still a joyous video. I'm the same person. I'm just moving by the unction of the Holy Ghost. It's for somebody. If it's not for you, if you're spelling joy the right way, praise God. Pray for those who don't. Pray for those who don't spell it right. Praise for those who's got it out of order in their life. Get off of yourself. Stop wallowing in your pity party. Get off your blessed assurance and move toward the kingdom of God. Let the will of God be done in you as it is in heaven. Do like Jesus did in the Garden of Gethsemane. Even though we know that the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. But you must wrestle with the Lord as Jacob did. You must say, Lord, if it's possible, let this cup pass from me of serving you and crucifying my flesh. But nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. You know, there's a day and a time for all things. To everything, there is a season. To everything, there is a season. Ecclesiastes 3:10, 3:11. But there is those days when you have to be in that midnight in the garden of good and evil. When you're wrestling with the Lord. When his will is bigger than your will. You got your own will bumping up against the will of God. That's when you have to do and follow the example of the Lord. Lord, if it's possible, let this cup pass from me. But if not, nevertheless, let thy will be done in my life. Let thy will be done in me as it is in heaven. Now, until you come to the place, you can't possibly get where God wants you to go until you come to that Garden of Gethsemane moment when you say, Lord, Let thy will be done in my life as it is in heaven. Lord, let have your way with me. Like that song, have your way in me. Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul. I live for you alone. Every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me. Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul. That's what you need to do. Give your heart and soul, your mind, which is your soul, your thinking, your heart and your body. All those three, the Bible tells, we're made up of three parts. Spirit, soul or mind, your consciousness, and your physical body. That's the three. We have three. Just like it is in heaven, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. It's also reflected on earth in man. And we have three parts, as the Bible says. Brothers and sisters, I want to pray for you right now. I want to pray for you right now in the name of Jesus. Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God, Lord, I speak right now the spirit of deliverance. I speak deliverance upon your people. Every obstacle, every hindrance be broken in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Let every obstacle and every hindrance be broken in Jesus' name. Right now, hallelujah, I speak liberty. For the Bible says where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise your Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. I speak praises to your name, Lord God. I sing praises to your name. Oh, Lord, praises to your name. Oh, Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. I sing glory to your name. Oh, Lord, glory to your name. Oh, Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Let's praise him. I sing honor to your name. Oh, Lord, honor to your name. Oh, Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Praise God Almighty. Praise God, Father, God, and the Holy Ghost. I'm trying to do the, what they call it, what is it, the doxology, whatever, in the hymn of the hymnal book, you know. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Hallelujah. Hallowed be his name. Hallelujah. He's King of kings and Lord of lords. The soon coming King. Hallelujah. The Lord Jesus Christ be with you and carry you and deliver you as he promised. He would be with you always, even to the end of the age. Hallelujah. He didn't never leave you nor forsake you. If God be for you, who could be against you? He is the King of kings and Lord of lords and captain of the host of the Lord's army. Hallelujah. Jesus reigns and rules. Hallelujah. The Lord is on the throne. Hallelujah. Forevermore. Hallelujah. Forevermore to be praised and worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Glory to his holy name. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of his thrones. He is worthy of all praise and glory. Hallelujah. Blessed be his holy name, his righteous name. God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. He is worthy. He is worthy. Hallelujah. Forevermore and evermore and evermore. He is King of kings and Lord of lords. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord God, Most High, Creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. Who establishes you and nurtures you and exalts you in due season. Hallelujah. For the day will come when he will lift you up. Hallelujah. Unto himself. Hallelujah. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trump of God. And the dead in Christ shall rise first. And those of us who are alive and remain shall be caught up together to meet the Lord in the air. So shall we forever be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. Blessed and glory and honor and praise is with our Lord. And the rewards are with him. Behold, he comes quickly. For a blood-bought, spotless bride, hallelujah, redeemed from man, hallelujah, set free, hallelujah, a glorious bride unto himself, hallelujah. He has called his people by his name, hallelujah, and his sheep hear his voice and answer not to another. For he is the Most High God, King of kings, Creator of heaven and earth, hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory forevermore and evermore and evermore. And evermore is our Lord and our God and our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Hallowed be his name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. God bless you, brothers and sisters. For all, you know, I keep trying to say that doxicology, you know, blessed, you know, to whom all blessings flow. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. That's what's in my spirit from the Lord. I haven't heard it in so long. I haven't been in a liturgical church in so long. I forgot exactly how to say it. But that's what the Lord is telling me to say, that what they call the doxology. God bless you guys right now, through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Blessed and hallowed be his name. Hallelujah. He is worthy. He is righteous. He is holy. He is everlasting to everlasting. Hallelujah. He's the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last, the King of kings and Lord of lords, the Alpha and Omega. Hallelujah. Blessed is his name. Hallowed is his name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord God Most High. Hallelujah. Give him glory. Give him glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. And the Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of his people. Begin to praise him. Begin to praise him. Hallelujah. And his Spirit will descend on you like a dove. Hallelujah. And break every chain in your life. Hallelujah. You need to be set free. You need to have your mind set free from the bonds of this world. That you would renew your mind with the Word of God. That you would bring into captivity every vain imagination that exalts itself against the Word of God. Hallelujah. You say this and God said that. You say God abandoned me, and God said I'll never leave you nor forsake you. You say God is not here, and Jesus said, behold, I'm with you always to the end of the age. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let God be true and every man a liar. Hallelujah. Has God not said it? Will he also not do it? Will he not also perform, hallelujah, what he declares he will do from the beginning, from the end? Hallelujah. He'll never leave you nor forsake you, and he'll be with you even to the end of the age. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Bring your vain imagination into captivity to the Word of God. Hallelujah. And don't call God a liar, but believe every word that proceeds out of his mouth, as Jesus said. Man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God Almighty. Praise God to whom all blessings flow from his throne. Hallelujah. Receive the blessings. I speak right now the blessings of the Most High God upon you. The God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, right now I release the patriarchal blessing that Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and Joseph walked in of overflowing abundance. Right now I speak it. Health, wealth, wisdom, peace, joy, and love in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. I release the patriarchal blessing on the children of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I ask you to receive it today. Receive that abundant overflow, like what Joseph walked in, more than enough. The ones to make it through the 7 years of famine, 7 years of fatness, 7 years of abundance, 7 years of overflowing in your life right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Blessed be the Most High God. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name. God bless you guys. God bless you. I keep going because the Lord is leading me. God bless you guys. God bless you. I can't say it enough. The Lord is telling me just to release the blessing. I release the blessing on you. I release the blessing of God on you. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The blessings of Joseph, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Go read the stories of these men of God, the servants of God, all the abundance they had in their life of wisdom, of favor. They were known as a prince among normal people. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and Joseph. They were known as princes among the world, amongst the worldly people. We're supposed to walk as princes also, princes and princesses among the world. We're supposed to be overflowing and oozing with the anointing oil of God, which this, like olive oil, represents. We're supposed to be, and that frankincense I'm going to put in here, that fragrance of God is supposed to be coming off of you. Not the fragrance of the world like smoke, like when Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego walked through the fiery furnace in Daniel. It says when they came out, King Nebuchadnezzar said, hey, they don't even smell like smoke. Their clothes don't even smell like smoke. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That people should smell the fragrance of God, of frankincense on you. Hallelujah. That comes from prayer, from fasting, from seeking the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God said, if you'll seek me, you'll find me if you search for me with all of your heart. It's from Jeremiah. Seek him with all your heart. Seek, Jesus said, and you shall find. Ask and it'll be given unto you. Knock and it'll be opened to you. Hallelujah. Seek, ask, and knock. Press in. God's going to bless you. He wants to bless you. He wants you to rule and reign. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We're supposed to rule and reign in this earth. Hallelujah. And occupy. Hallelujah. Have authority. Jesus said, I give you all authority over the power of the enemy. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Walk in what God gave you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. What if somebody gave you $1 million to start a business and you took $900,000, threw it away, and took $100,000 to start a business? Just throw away $900,000. And do a $100,000 business. God gave you $1 million worth of blessings, $1 million worth of wisdom, $1 million worth of talent, $1 million worth of anointing, you know, unlimited, all of those things. And you're fighting with one hand tied behind your back. One eye shut. Open your eyes that God gave you. Open your ears that God gave you. Put on the armor that God gave you. Get the sword that God gave you. Use the things that God gave you. Hallelujah. For the victory belongs to his people. Hallelujah. The victory is ours. You know, as that song goes, victory is mine, victory is mine, victory today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind, victory today is mine. Hallelujah. Praise his name. Blessing and honor and glory. Victory is mine, victory is yours. In Christ Jesus, through Jesus, we got the victory. Sing hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise be his holy name. Brothers and sisters, I better go. Save a little bit more for next time. God bless you guys. I love you guys. You know, God is good all the time. He's been so good. I'll be going to a church here toward the end of the month in Western North Carolina. As a matter of fact, for two weekends in a row, I'll be going up to the mountains of North Carolina. God bless you guys. I don't know when I'm going to make it across. It's up to the Lord to go on to Nashville and all those places. Still waiting to hear from the Lord. It's totally up to him. It's totally cool with me, whatever he wants to do. I'm ready, willing, and obedient, and trying to hear to go flow in his spirit. God bless you guys. Love you guys. See you soon.